In this video, we're going to look at some of the signs that indicate that your house may need rewiring. Whether it was installed in the 1960s, the 1970s, or the 1980s, or even if you live in a Victorian house, we'll help you figure out if you need to call in an electrician. Now, just to reassure you, this video is not designed to convince you that your house desperately needs rewiring, and it's not designed to persuade you out of having essential work carried out. The goal is simply to explain some things about the electrical installation in your house so you can make an informed decision. Now, you may have found yourself in a situation where maybe you're moving house and a report from a solicitor has informed you that your property needs rewiring. Or you may have arranged for an electrician to come and do some work on your property, maybe as little as adding a socket or two, installing an EV charger, fitting solar panels, or even to the extent of having an extension built. And they're gravely announcing that they can't do the work unless the existing wiring is improved. Now, this may well strike you as being a bit odd because you've never noticed a problem with the electrics in your house. Everything's working just fine. However, some electrical installations are so old that they may be missing certain key safety elements that are now pretty much essential in new installations. So let's have a look at some of the clues that indicate that you may need a rewire. Number one, look at the fuse box. If your fuse box looks like the ones that you can see in these pictures, then that is an indication that the wiring behind it is older and may be in need of replacing. In addition, this type of fuse box is missing some critical forms of protection that can make your installation safer. A rewire combined with a new fuse box or consumer unit will provide you with something called an RCD that helps to protect users from electric shock, and an SPD which can protect your appliances from damaging surges in the electrical supply. Number two, sockets and switches. Another clue can be found by looking at your switches and sockets. Now, the one you can see in this picture is made of an old plastic called Bakelite. And again, if they look like this, then it's possible that older wiring may be in place behind it and may need replacing. You'll notice, however, I'm saying maybe and could be. And this is because there's a number of companies who produce new switches to look like these old ones, to kind of give a vintage effect to a space, or even for use in period properties. However, it can be another clue to help you make a decision. Just a word of caution on this one though, it's possible that someone may have come in and changed all the socket and switch fronts in your house to kind of spruce a property up before sale, without actually replacing any old degraded wiring behind them. However, if your socket outlets, for example, look a little bit older and yellowed or even damaged, then again, that's an indication that there may be old, unsuitable cable behind it. Speaking of which, number three, cables. Nowadays, we tend to install cables that look like this. They're insulated with PVC with an outer sheath also made of PVC. Now, if you look around your property, you may be able to see some of the existing cables, maybe running outside to a socket, maybe around your fuse box, or even in the loft if you can access it. Older installations used to be wired up in cables that look like this. It's insulated in vulcanized India rubber, or VIR as it's shortened to. And over time, this insulation has a tendency to turn brittle and break away. So if the cables in your house look like this, they'll probably need replacing. Or you may have cables that look like this. You can see that the surface has a kind of dull metallic sheen to it. And that's because this kind of cable is coated in a lead sheath to protect it from damage. Again, this is an indication that the cable is old and will likely need replacing. Number four, earth connections. If you've ever replaced or removed a switch or a socket in your house, you may have noticed that the cables have three conductors in them. You can see them here. This one and this one make the electrical system work. So when you plug in, say, your kettle, if either one of these isn't connected, it simply won't turn on, and you know there's a problem with one of these conductors. This middle conductor, however, is the safety conductor. It's the one that connects to the metal bodywork of an appliance, providing a connection to earth. This conductor is actually often called the earth, but if you really want to impress your electrician, call it the CPC. You'll blow their mind. Now, if this conductor is not properly connected, most appliances will continue to work perfectly and you'll have no idea that it isn't connected to earth, until something goes wrong inside the appliance and the metal body becomes live. If someone then touches it, they could receive a dangerous, possibly even lethal shock. If you've ever opened up a socket or a switch and not seen this green and yellow conductor, then it's possible you'll need the cables replacing with ones that include it. Number 5, correct insulation. While we've got this socket off, you can see the insulation here is in good condition, but if it's cracked and brittle, then that's a sign that the electrical installation is aging and may be ready to get replaced. Number 6, cable colours. Now you may have noticed that compared to the cable we looked at on the bench earlier, these conductors are a different colour to the ones that we looked at. And that's because back in 2004, the colours that we used to identify the conductors was changed in order to harmonise with European colours. Now, while a house wouldn't need rewiring just to update the colours, it can give you an idea of how old the installation is. If the colours of the conductors in your property are black and red, then it was installed before 2004 and may even be decades old, especially if the green and yellow conductor is just a solid green instead. If, however, the conductors are brown and blue, then you know that the installation was carried out after 2004. Number 7, rodent damage. Now, this might not be the first thing that you think of when looking at your property and considering if it needs rewiring. However, in older houses, it's not uncommon to find that rats or mice have been gnawing on the insulation around the cables and have caused live parts to be exposed, leading to a danger of shock or fire. This type of damage is likely to be most apparent in areas like the loft or the cellar if you've got one. And if it's extensive enough, it may even need rewiring with a wiring system that's designed to prevent vermin from damaging the cables again. Number 8, convenience of the installation. Finally, you may just want to think about if the current installation is working for you. Do you find yourself running extension leads all over the place because you don't have enough sockets, or perhaps they're in the wrong places? Again, in times past, it was kind of standard practice to put one socket in each room, and that was considered to be enough. If the numbers of sockets are on the low side in your installation, then it's possible that that installation is a little bit older and may need rewiring, or you may just want to add some extra points. So we hope this video has helped you to understand a little bit more about some of the reasons you might want to consider a rewire. For further information on the electrical installation in your home, please check out our other videos that we've made. And if you think you are in need of a rewire, then get in touch with your local electrician who will be able to advise you further. For further information, please head to electrium.co.uk. All that remains in this video is to say thank you very much for watching.